London has changed since the last coronation 26 years ago, but nowhere more than in Regent Street. The face of Regent Street may have been lifted, but it still remains one of the most famous shopping streets of the world. But today, that's all different. Shop windows, instead of displaying flashing jewels and gorgeous gowns, are as tightly packed with cheering coronation watchers as the jammed pavements. And now it's Oxford Street that vibrates to the tramp of marching feet, that glitters to the sparkle of flashing swords, that echoes to the voice of 100,000 throats, the Canadian Northwest Mounted Police. The guards. The Colonial. Under Marble Arch and into Hyde Park, and at last the procession is heading for home. The men from the Empire's armies. The Anzacs and the Royal Air Force. The Canadians. Through the park, where every tree is a grandstand, it's mile after mile of swinging men and prancing horses. And amongst the glittering uniforms and waving plumes, not the smallest corner of the Empire is forgotten. Not one branch of its life is unrepresented. Here's the RAF band. A last glimpse of Mr. Stanley Baldwin, for whom this day marks the climax of a distinguished career. Her Royal Highness the Duchess of Kent, the band of the Royal Scots Greys. The band and bugles of the Rifle Brigade. Colonial contingent. Pipes and band of the King's Own Scottish Borderers. Yeomen of the Guard. The King's Barge Master and Waterman. The King's Indian Escort. And band of the Highland Light Infantry. The Territorial Army. The Royal Navy. The Canadians. Royal Dukes. The Guards. The Royal Duchesses. Prince and Princess Arthur of Connaught and Princess Alice, Countess of Athlone.